Well, we've got quite used to seeing rockets go up into space and men walking about on the moon, but that doesn't seem to have been happening lately, Peter. Why is that?
Well, it's been very expensive to go up into space in the past, and now that we've had a good look at the moon, we don't want to go there anymore. And so what they've been doing is really saving up their money until they can afford a great new spaceship, and they're just about to have it in a few years' time, and we've got a model of it over here. It's called the Space Shuttle. And this is really more like a plane than a spaceship, because as you can see, it's got a body and it's got a tail and it's got little wings and it's got rocket motors on the back. And with this space plane, which is called the Space Shuttle because it will shuttle backwards and forwards into space, in other words, go up from the Earth into space and then down to the Earth and then turn around and take off again up into space and shuttle men and women too up and down into space. This will be going up into space in the 1980s at the rate of about one flight a week, so that lots and lots of people soon will be going on into space. Now, the first of the real space shuttles is now being built in America, and this part will come out into space, and this is really a sort of a workroom, rather like Mother's Kitchen, where men and women will do their work in space. And then they will use the instruments and the tools at the back here for doing things out in space, wearing one of those spacesuits like we saw Wally Wyton wearing when they get out in the darkness and in the cold.
So what sort of things are they going to do?
Well, they're going to do lots of things. Firstly, they're going to use these things to look up at the stars and at the sun and study those, and also to find other stars which we may want to go to later on. And they're going to look down at the Earth and look at the clouds and the oceans and try and get better weather forecasts and things like that. And they're also going to launch satellites from this space plane. Mm. We've got some of the satellites or models of them here, you can see. And the advantage of doing it from here is that instead of just shooting them into the sky with a rocket, you can drive the space plane up into orbit and then take the satellite out, open a door and put it out into space very carefully, and it will stay there just where you want it, and it's cheaper to do it that way than sending it up with a rocket. And then finally, they will use these space planes to carry large pieces of metal up into space to make a kind of great big house from which they can launch rockets and other space planes on towards the stars in the future so that we can eventually get away from Earth.
Mm. And is anybody going to have a chance to go up in the shuttle?
This is the really exciting thing, because up till now it's been either the Americans or the Russians, but the Americans have kindly said that anyone who has a bright idea for something to do in space and cares to put it forward will get a chance to go up in this thing when they're grown up and actually do the job up there. And they've offered this chance to British children and British astronauts if they care to train themselves for going up. So we will be able to go up, children will be able to go up, and it will be a very exciting thing for British people in the future.
Peter, thank you. So who knows, if you've got a good idea, you may be able to go up into space.